hard to examine a 2-, 3-, or 4-year-old who doesn't respond in the way that you're used to.
The child isn't able to tell you if they can see, if they see double, if they see blurry. They just know what they've seen their whole life. It's kind of amazing as a pediatric eye doctor to be able to be that voice for them.
80% of learning in school is done via the visual system, and approximately 1 in 10 children has a vision problem that's substantial enough to clearly impact their ability to learn. Every child deserves the same starting opportunity to succeed in life. It is crucial to catch vision problems when children are young because that's when we have the biggest impact. At the University Eye Center, we treat the whole child. We determine, do they need glasses? Are the eyes healthy? Or do we need to go a little bit further? Yaya's very fortunate that mom had the foresight to bring him in for an eye exam.
I was scared, say maybe in the future, my son gonna be blind.
Tell me what you see, okay? Yaya, what's this right here? Excellent job. What's that one right here? You wanna get closer?
When Yaya came to see us last fall, he was about to have 3 evaluations in his educational setting. The school did not feel like he was keeping up with his peers. On our eye exam, we discovered he couldn't see beyond 2 or 3 inches from his face. So one could imagine how that could impact your school performance.
After the glasses that come for the checkup, they will see a lot of improvement, so I was so happy for that.
Put these over your head like that, slide them on. Fantastic. How do they feel? What's that? Excellent. And this one?
Once Yaya received the glasses, he had the evaluations and passed them, totally changing the course of his school career.
The school now is doing progress. Even on the trend is nonstop, mommy, ABC, I see a lot of change.
What's great about pediatric eye care is that sometimes when you see one child, you can find things that run in families.
She say, do you mind check all of them? So I bring the other 2. If she was not telling me that, I was not gonna know Mariam needed glasses. And I can come check mine also, I never get it done.
We love to say that when we treat the child, we not only treat the patient, but we treat the whole family. If Yaya hadn't been treated, we can't really say what his future would have been. I think it would have been very difficult for him to learn in school. He wouldn't have even been able to see the things close enough to him on his desk, let alone things written on the board.
Our life is changed. I'm happy for it. All the doctors, they always smiling, stay high. Everybody loves their job here. I feel like I come to the right place.
We serve thousands of patients like Yaya, and it's our ambition to have every one of them have the same kind of experience and for us to have a positive impact on their lives. Construction for the new pediatric eye care center is going to begin this fall. It's a 2.5 million, 4,900 square foot state-of-the-art facility, but it's really much more. It's really about changes in the way we deliver pediatric eye care. We have designed the center to advance interdisciplinary team-based care, enhance care coordination, support our clinical research efforts, and improve patient outcomes, all while providing a warm, welcoming, family-centered experience. One of the most central design features of the Center for Pediatric Eye Care is what's known as the collaboration zone. The collaboration zone is an area where the healthcare team can work together with immediate access to all 8 of our diagnostic, treatment, and examination rooms. To date, we've raised $2 million of the $2.5 million that we need. All of tonight's proceeds are going to go towards achieving that goal. We need to remember that the goal is not simply to build a facility, but rather to create a vision and implement a vision for pediatric eye care going into the future. Thank you for your support.